Hey guys, this is Kirob speaking, and today we are not in automation. This isn't tank automation either. And no, we're in War Thunder. In War Thunder, it's a free-to-play game, which you just go ahead and download. And for me, it so far has been completely free and a ton of fun. I've played around 160 hours of it, and I would say average, very much average. I have some moments of brilliance, followed by many moments of complete failure, and I think from even good players it's kind of like that at times. Anyway, so it is a lot of fun to come back to from time to time and just have good old time driving tanks and shooting at the enemies. But it's rather intriguing with its systems, and also it's a bit weird in its game design decisions. But let's take a look. What does this game, what makes this game so unique? I would say it is the precise modeling of the tanks. As you can see in here, we have our crew sitting in here, which is reasonably simulated. Your crew members can take damage. They are based on a hit point system, which is invisible. But they can get killed off or wounded, so they perform their actions slower. And all the components in here can be hit individually and knocked out. So when you are fighting different tanks, and for instance you would want to kind of stop me moving here when I'm driving this tank, you would aim for the engine and try to set it on fire, like shoot right through the back or just through the side, rear side armor, and try to set it on fire, which stops the tank. You could also do that by shooting the driver, of course, so that they first have to remove him or whatever remains of him, and then place someone else there to drive the tank. And yes. So overall, it's pretty realistic. I think as realistic as tank games get. There might be some weird simulators out there, which I don't know of, which are more accurate. But certainly going more realistic than this, for instance, simulator mode, comes with other difficulties, like pacing and so on. So this is really not that interesting to me. I want to have a good balance between a good old action, driving around, shooting stuff, seeing nice explosions, but also a touch of, let's say, believability. Believability also comes from the game's armor system. You can bounce shots, and in order for the tank to be penetrated by the penetrator, you have to first get through the armor. And you have different armor plates on each tank. Every tank is modeled differently and reasonably accurately. And for instance, this turret isn't the most secure. For example, the lower glacis here has 80 millimeters of rolled armor, while the turret only has 50 millimeters and from the sides 30. So it's much easier to get through the turret side or through the turret mantle. Well, no, not really the mantle. The mantle also has 50 mil, but like the cheeks of the turret. That's super easy to get through. And who's behind there? Let's take a look. So if you want to make sure that I don't shoot at you in the coming few seconds, then you certainly should aim for the right-hand cheek. So what more is there about the game? Well, there are tons of modifications for your tank, just upgrading it, making it better. And as you can see here, this tank is almost fully upgraded. And yeah, so you start with a very basic tank, and then you modify various parts along the way, which you unlock via experience, which you gain through matches, and so on. So it's kind of standard progression scheme in here. But what is more interesting is the progression in the tech. You start out very early war, World War II, like with pre-war tech basically, and from there work your way forwards until late war tech and even post-war tech, like the Leopard and stuff. And they play very differently because warfare evolved so much during that time. Pretty cool to see and to play. Although you certainly will see more Rambo action stuff than proper tactics, battlefield tactics in this game. At least in tank realistic battles and arcade battles especially, which are kind of hilarious to watch. Anyway, just some technical note. I'm recording this barely capable at 720p. That is because I can't seem to be using Fraps for recording the raw video footage without encoding it first. That's usually my go-to thing I do. So now I'm recording with OBS, and that is encoding into an MP4 right away, which is good for its size, but it takes more processing power, and my PC seems to be a bit on the weak side when it comes to that. So if there is the occasional stutter, it will be because of that. And this is also just a trial balloon to see if you like it, and see if this makes any sense now to be recording this on this machine. Anyway, so let's get into a battle and see what this is all about. Ah yes, Stalingrad. The only thing I really know is that a lot of people are trying to get around the back end there. So let's see if we can't meet them.
We are moving along at a fair lick.
Alright, now a little bit careful maybe. Because those bastards can easily shoot me dead, very dead, extremely dead even, and I have no real cover over here. Everyone's trying to get a shot. Is this a KV-2 standing there? No, it's a flak truck, and now he's dead.
Cover me.
Let me just drive through here. See if we can't... Oh shit, everyone's dying. Is that a... tank? Nope. No tank there. Okay. This is a little bit risky. All the way back there is someone, but I don't think I can shoot him. Or maybe. Yep, I definitely could. That was a good shot. Got his cannon breached, so he won't be shooting back in a while. There's a ricochet, it's bad. Come on, lower, 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 and there. Yes, got through his transmission, and there's someone else coming in. A bit further down the line. Ground target destroyed, very nice. Now focusing on him again. And we got him too. Very nice. Alright, that was a bit unexpected for them. What a nice hidey spot. Took out three. Can we focus down anyone else? This dude, for instance. Let me just move up a bit. Don't want to be caught out in this exact same spot. Now we can just remove a few things here. Do we see someone there? Ouch! Yep. That was probably someone I killed before. Nice revenge kill, dude. Well done. And I think I'm going to take the Panzer IV G. Fuck you, man! He was getting around there spawn camping and shit. And he got destroyed. But he took out two of my guys in the process. I wonder how he managed to destroy so little inside my tank while still killing two people. Must be the shitty shells they're having. No explosive filler, and that is entirely possible. Let's see if someone is around the corner here. Seems all clear. Oh, there's someone. Let's see if he did see me.
Repairing.
Or if he's... He was just trying to move through, but nope, I didn't allow for that. Little bastard. Caught him out, didn't see me. Trying to flank around like a pro. This seems all clear. Whoa. Or not. It's this bastard. Let's see if we can't get him. I think he's coming in again. From up high. Yeah, he is. So let's drive forward because he's coming in at a very steep angle. So we shorten it even more. Then he can't really get us. I hope at least. Ah, he's trying to get me. But I can just move inside the building, I guess. I'm not taking your shit anymore. Because he would be marking me on the map every time he hits me. And hitting me isn't that difficult. It's just annoying. He wouldn't be getting through my armor, it seems. Even maybe he should have tried getting even steeper at me, because he certainly can penetrate the engine deck. Where the hell did that shot come from? Ah, fuck. Alright, you got me. Oh, back there, yeah.
Damn it, damn it, damn it.
Allied forces have captured the zone.
Let's take out the Stug. Are there spawn campers? I don't see anyone. I think the M10 had to go to A, or at least try to push it, as time is running out for them. Ah, there they go. Now they're capturing A, trying to. Let's see if we can flank around. I don't see anyone. Where are they?
Reloading.
Somewhere there. I think he got one. Yeah, there's the carcass, the flaming one. But where are the others? Oh, right over there. Here? No, it's just my colleague. So where did he go? Whoa! He got shot. Oh! Fuck! From where?
Allied forces have captured a zone.
Ah, fucking hell! Now I can't drive. Yes, drive into my shot. Please drive it into my shot and. Why didn't we hit a thing? What?
That's stupid.
I don't get it. Why didn't we hit him? Nah, I don't think we are going out with another one. Like destroying... Oh, wait. We still have two guys there, it seems. Do I have backups for my Panzer IV? Don't really want to take the Dicker Max, as that is ridiculous. Yeah, let's go out with this one. There's someone right over there. Let's bomb this section up. Wow.
Let's keep the pressure on.
He was killed pretty quick. So let's take this a little slowly. We're kind of safe from this angle. Still have a bit of time. There's someone coming. Oh shit, that was a bad miss. Right, got him. A little bit at least. Yes, alright. Knocked him out. Now it's just a question of where are the others. Ah, fucking hell. That was from the side somewhere. From where? Ah, shit. 17 pounder got me M10 once again. From there, I... What? That was really close. Oh, no, 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 it was not close. That was really difficult to see. Anyway, that's it for me, it seems. I can't get back in, and I think the enemy has clutched the game. Really, really closely. Yep, that's it. Let's take a look at the game summary. Whew! That wasn't too bad. 26k. And we don't have the experience yet. We can't see it yet because the game isn't over yet. So once that is done, I will be getting the experience too. But overall, pretty good.
Ah, the advance to the Rhine. Yes, this is in Cologne, I think.
And we're starting from down here, and I think I can just pass by B and then continue down here and look up this lane, which is always dangerous. And a good flanking maneuver to get around there. If you control this lane, then you're pretty much set. Alright. Panzer 4, Panzer 4, H, yes, J. Alright, we can capture B really quick and then just continue on. I think we are standing pretty safe over here. Artillery fire, yes. Moving on soon.
Allied forces have captured a zone. Enemy forces have captured a zone.
Attention to the designated grid zone!
Ouch! A bit of shrapnel right there. Didn't hurt us though. Now we have another Panzer 4G in front of us to take the brunt. Whoa! Damn, son. This is not rally driving here. So, how are you doing? Whoa, 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 whoa. Where is he? Okay. Ah, oh! Fucking hell! Didn't see that guy. Uh, Ah, now they are trying to capture C. Let's get C hammered.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
Is there someone around the corner here, is my question. Oh, there's no one there. Alright. Let's have a look here. Okay, I hit someone, so there's definitely someone in here. Question is where? There he is. Okay, got him critical. Got his gunner. And there we go. Nice shot right there.
Enemy forces have captured a zone.
And got him too. Whoa, shit. Let's rotate out of the way. Uh oh, we got bombs. Ooh, okay. That's dangerous. Oh, fuck. Alright, but now our tracks are back. Back in shape. Oh. Didn't look there. I was very, very lucky. Fucking up. No. Whoa.
Attention to the map.
I'm over there. What? Didn't we hit anything? What the hell? What happened there? Okay, now we're fucked. But yeah, it was a good run. Too many enemies right there.
Attention to the map!
Alright, now it's time for the Dicker Max.
And we're driving in the wrong direction. Why are we driving in the wrong direction?
Oh, come on, fat bastard. Turn.
Can't be that bad. This is pretty much unupgraded, so it's horribly slow. There's someone over there, so probably trying to flank around like crazy. I hope they're moving in here, this lane. I doubt it. Maybe we can get him here. Whoa, there's some shooting going on. What? He got hit by a shrapnel? Or by a... Okay, we only have one shot to make that one count, if you see him. There we go, and... Take that one. Boom. Okay, he got him. Because the other one was preoccupied. Yeah, one of these mediocre games has a few moments which are really cool, and then, well, for the rest, not really. Basically a clusterfuck of failure on my end. Used all kinds of tanks, all got destroyed. But, I got this new shell here, which is really handy for fighting higher tier enemies, as this one has 191 millimeters of penetration at 500 meters. That's a lot of armor it can go through. It's pretty fast. And the best thing about it is the 300 grams of TNT equivalent, so basically one-shot master. Ash River! Kind of a classic. Is there anyone in the sniper spot? I don't think there is. That's weird. Alright, let's take the sniper spot.
I beg your pardon.
Is someone in their sniper spot? Not yet, it seems. Just an AI. Fuck. Just kill assist.
Wow, that was a nice shot. There we go! Another nice shot. So far, so good.
Good location. Just don't forget to back off slightly between the shots. Not getting too overconfident. And there's another one. Hold still so I can hit you. Whoa! Too high! That was bad. Really bad.
And another one down. And got that one too, although we lost our machine gunner. Was a bit risky.
If we don't do something fast, the enemy will win.
Oh, there's an enemy driving. And there we go, critical hit. Very nice shot. There's another one. Critical hit, got his transmission and everything. Now he's trying to find me. And will it be too late? Oh, shit. It's a bad shot. Make it a little bit more difficult for him. There we go, another hit. A little bit higher. Aim for it. Fire! There we go. True not out. And do we have more sniping to do? Who's crying for help? Where? There. There's the other one. There we go. Critical hit and fire. There's another one. And another critical hit. Can we get that one over there? Ape, you fucking asshole! Stop! Stop, you fucker! Gotta repair now. Those bastards. Fuck, too high.
Got the tree. There he is.
Ah, right. That was a bad shot. Got another one into him, but whoa! Someone shooting from there. Where is he? Over there. Long range. Already dead. And over there too. Ah, I did see him right as the shot was coming down. I hit into him. He will have a hard time hitting me here. Critical hit. Now you can't leave. And kill assist. Nope. Oh, now they are pissed at me. Yes, now they're really pissed off. And throwing bombs at me. And I'm completely out of ammo! Fuck. I have to go to A to reload. And here we have the stats. Wow, so much research. That's how you do R&D, folks.
add-on armor almost complete. And we did get, let's take a look. So it remained at 5 kills and 4 assists with 0 deaths, so that was a pretty good game, mainly due to my sniping powers. And yes, I think that's a pretty good more or less tank destroyer gameplay, even though I played a normal medium tank, not tank destroyer, where you just sit in a spot and snipe for a while, and this time it seemed to be working out pretty well. So I hope cut together that was kind of neat to look at, even though I fucked up quite a few shots.